So now, as Dr. Vivek was saying, we shall be talking something about specifics. And even as I come and stand before you, the future is already knocking on my door, asking to be given a chance to speak first. So we'll come to that a little bit later. I have no commercial interests, unfortunately, in the contents of this presentation as of now. We talk about the present state of IOL power calculations and how the future is poised for us. So the present state, we have a lot of formulas that are available with us, which we use on a regular basis, and these are pretty good. These formulas work well for us. So why change? Why should we, you know, cross that Lakshman Rekha, step out of our comfort zone, and do something which we are really not very comfortable doing? So the answer is that there are actually two answers here. We need to change, that's one. Secondly, we can change. Sometimes we do things just because we can. So we'll come to that a little bit later. Now, the need to change arises from two things. One, that patient expectations are increasing, especially as we go into premium IOLs. And even with the best of current formulas and approaches, there's still a good margin of error that remains. And so there's room for improvement at the top. So that's about the need to change. And we have a capacity to change today. The hardware capabilities of machines are increasing by the day. We have newer learning capacities and strategies for these machines. So newer algorithms are coming in, so we can learn better. Now, as Dr. Vivek mentioned, data is increasing exponentially. We have more data available, which then translates into a better model for the machines. Apart from being more voluminous, the quality of the data is also getting better. As we are doing electronic medical records, the consistency and the nature of the data is conforming more and more to standards, and so we can get more useful insights out of this data. So the capacity to change is also improving for us. Now, as far as IOL power formulas are concerned, in the past couple of years, maybe 1 or 2 years, there have been a number of approaches that have been published regarding AI modalities in IOL power calculation. And I mentioned 2 or 3 of the more famous ones. I think everybody today has heard of the Hill RBF formula. The others are the LADAS Super Formula 2 and the Pearl DGS, which I mentioned. Now, talking about Hill RBF, this RBF stands for Radial Basis Function. It's a formula based on artificial neural networks, and it's a purely data-driven approach. So we are no longer talking about theoretical concerns or Gaussian optics of the eye. We just put data into the model puts out an IOL power result for us. It is said to be free of the limitations of ELP estimation, which is one of the bugbears of IOL power formulas. However, even the Hill RBF, promising as it is, it has certain limitations. The second version, version 2, has been trained on 12,419 eyes, which is a big improvement. The first one was trained on close to 4,000 eyes. The limitation is that it's working basically on data fed to it through LensStar biometry and on a single model of IOL. So if you are using the Hill RBF to calculate for your own patients, you would necessarily be extrapolating from what it has learned to what it's happening in your practice. And that extrapolation has a problem because machine learning models are very, very sensitive to the kind of data you input into them. And we are not really sure whether the extrapolation is going to be accurate or not. And this is also borne out in clinical results, because as of today, Hill RBF has not been shown to be conclusively better than the other formulas. So for example, a Barrett's Universal 2 or even a well-optimized third generation formula works just as well. Which is not to say that we don't use Hill RBF, but maybe it's not yet reached the potential that it could. Coming to LADAS 2, if anybody's ever used LADAS 1, which was a three-dimensional surface of IOL power, now they have gone into version 2 and they're trying to add an element of machine learning onto their existing version 1 model, and they claim that it's going to be better because they have a basemark frame of reference, which is the LADAS 1 formula. And therefore, the problem that Hill RBF sometimes presents to us, which they call out of bounds, if the machine learning model is not fully equipped to deal with that given situation. The LADAS 2 is said to not encounter that problem. It is available for beta testing online. You can just Google LADAS 2.0 and you can enroll and you can, you know, check it out yourself. Now, as far as approaches that use AI for calculation of IOL power are concerned, what can I do as a clinician? So these formulas today are available free of cost. So I don't need to really do too much. I need to be ready to adapt. I need to be ready to audit my data because I need to see how the formula is doing actually. And for that, I need to, get ready to keep detailed records. It may not be very, comfortable for me, but I need to maintain those records. And finally, once I do these things, then I need to be prepared for better results. So the take-home message is that many new oil power calculation strategies are emerging, and you have to try them out and see for yourself how they fare. As Dr. Vivek has said, if we don't do this, we may get left behind. However, be wary of accepting things just because they are new and in vogue. Do take the time, do test it out yourself with an open mind. Thank you.